How's it going? This is Dimas Prince. Today I want to talk about one important topic that is buffer listing. The Emacs hackers, we used to keep a long open session of Emacs. This is mainly because we like to run Emacs as a server. So whenever we want to visit one file, we visit in the same Emacs session. We don't open a new one. So let's say I have this session open during the last 20 days and I have accumulated couple of thousand buffers. So let's say I want to open a new file, this guy. So this guy is going to be open in my same session, you see? So this is very convenient, and this is the reason why we accumulate many open buffers. So I use a buffer library. It's very highly customizable library. I will show you how it looks in my setup. So I like to separate the information to be presented in different programming languages. So here I have Emacs-list buffers, I have CommonList, Haskell. Every time I learn a new programming language, I do a couple of things. I download one library, one major mod for the language, and I update my buffer setting to recognize the major mod. So let's say I want to visit one buffer of this couple of thousand, and I remember the name because I have good memory, so you can just jump on it. But usually you don't remember the name. So let's say I remember something about Drago. One good guess will be to try to search by name using Drago keyword, and I'm lucky in this case I found it. But we can imagine that maybe I don't remember anything about the name of the buffer, but I remember a bit about the content. So I remember one buffer that contained the word bleed. So we can search all the buffers by content, and luckily only a couple of them will contain this string. Yeah, we found it. So you can imagine how having many buffers is not really so bad. The thing is, you always need to have the things under control. You need to be able to found all the information. So this is a bit of cumbersome, right? There are many buffers, but a buffer let you to use filters. Let's say I want to just focus in C++ buffers. So you can add one filter and restrict to just buffers in C++ mode. And now we have only 58 buffers. Nothing has been deleted. Only you are filtering to present this information. You can put on top another buffer, another filter, and combine them. So let's say I want the C and C++. So you can do something like that. Combine them. You see, you get the point. And we can also add now a Emacs list. And again, we combine them. Very good, and now if we want, we can delete all these filters, and again we show the original couple of thousand buffers. So yeah, you can use, I recommend you to learn and customize in your taste, and you will find that you will access all your information without any problem. You will not lose anything, and you will be extremely efficient. So please take a look and learn how to use this kind of thing. Drago! Drago! Thank you very much for your attention.